Right over there, you see that clappy? What's up, everybody? Yeah! So I've been exploring it a little bit. Been exploring, so there was nothing more interesting, just some empty ruins. Except this echo log. And I found, just got in and already found a dead clappy. What's... He drowned, he fell from a great height. Let's see what the other dude says. Yeah, we're starting this one with a bang! Hell yeah! So, in the last episode I found this amazing sniper rifle. It penetrates and devastates enemies like there's no tomorrow with critical hits penetrating, yeah? Let's see the arsenal. This weapon, I'll use it a little bit, even though I have some superior weapons than that. Have this quote-unquote shotgun that shoots straight dishes or discs. That can't be classified as a shotgun. This beautiful pistol that I found, the ability of it. Huge bullet spread, anti-sniper rifle, which I want to give it a shot. And let me see how I get the hell out of here. It looks like I'm on the right track. It's just over here. And I can't charge this. It's just point and shoot. No charging required.
Too many to count.
So, what's up with you guys? What's going on? Look at them, they got aggressive since I left.
But yours was thrilling.
I remember they were barely scratching the surface.
How
hey, you!
Swoop and tear!
Of course, when we get over this epidemic and events in the future, this won't be relevant.
Trick.
This question won't be relevant, but it's relevant now. Since everybody is stuck at home, so how's your week going? Are you bored? Are you happy? Well, be quarantined at home, lost work, etc, etc. You know the details. So what's up with you all? Something hidden here, I'm sure.
Shiny box.
I knew it. 4,000 will take myself. Hey you! You're so mean. What? Where? Good boy. You!
Run.
Yes, you!
Run, you weaklings!
Don't even try. 6,000, that's very good. Inventory full. What? Yeah, for a while. Why are you speaking now? I need to sell my trash. There's no shops nearby. Go back to sell my trash.
We
now,
want a happy
hold on.
Family. Then later, she. Well, she died. And I had to raise the kids alone. I thought opening a vault would be the hottest thing I'd ever do. Was I wrong?
Wait, you've got kids, Typhon?
Yeah, two of them. The boy, he got sick all the time. And my daughter talked circles around me. Only time they'd sit still was to hear about my adventures. Killing monsters, opening vaults, being a hero. They couldn't get enough. I filled their heads with all sorts of stories. Even told them about the Great Vault. That was a mistake. A story can be a dangerous thing in the wrong hands.
You know who he's referring to, right? Well, just in case you didn't know, he's referring to two of them, which is Troy Calypso and Toyrin Calypso, the twin. Villain of this game, right? That's his kids, well, etc, etc. Surprise? Spoilers? Yes.
Later, she was so happy being here. She just kept running around, raiding ruins, and slapping my ass. True story! Then we see the vault in the distance.
Yeah, good story, bruh. Surprise, surprise. Spend Guardian tokens. They still didn't fix it. Gearbox B unlocks the player's skin hex bolts. Why the hell do I need skin? Why should I care about skins? I'm playing by myself. Don't even see those skins. Like skins and weapon cosmetics, I could care less about. I don't care about them in games whatsoever. I do like a good looking shotgun, but that's it. But I won't pay money for skins, like never ever, don't even bother with it. I won't even pay for DLC, so making me pay for skins, slim to miserable none. Don't even try. Like those Candy Crush games, if you don't have enough lives, oh come on, pay us some money, we'll give you extra life. Yeah, go suck yourselves. You really think I'm gonna pay you money for lives? You're dreaming. They want $15 for DLC. Full-fledged or not, I don't know, I didn't watch reviews yet. Doesn't matter, I won't buy it yet. I paid for a full-fledged game that cost $60. It wasn't a season pass, but so what? You make DLCs, I should have them, I shouldn't pay for a piece of content that may or may not be there in the first place. From what I probably understand or believe, it probably wasn't there, but I don't care that they make a new DLC now and they want another $15 for it. No one do DLCs like The Witcher, which CD Projekt Red did. No one. Pay Gearbox for more DLCs. Pay Ubisoft for more DLCs. Buy some Hexicon store, whatever, Assassin's Creed, etc, etc. Other like Star Wars Battlefront 2. Forget it, those companies think they're gonna drink people dry. Forget it, I'm not paying a penny more than the game itself. And I don't care if stuff are blocked behind it. There are two DLCs available now for this game, $15 each. I won't be paying for it. I'm playing the best game, whatever it offers. I beat the game. If I still like it, in this case it's Borderlands, I'll play it more, but paying more money for DLCs, forget it. I'm still living in 2001 when you paying for a disc full-fledged game, DLCs or not, the whole content was there, no bugs almost. There's no game in existence, I don't have bug. Would you catch my drift? I shouldn't pay $15, $20, $10, whatever for a piece of DLC or cosmetic that may or may been there or just added now, later on. I don't care. Pay $60 so you can go fridge yourself. They can go home expecting more money. Yeah, people do it, people buy it. From Angry Joe, from Review Tech USA Richie, he said they made billions in... Billions! EA made billions in microtransactions. I won't pay, I won't pay. I bought the full game, that's it. Whatever comes about it, or more add-ons, I won't be paying. I always, always buy the standard version. Never I'm gonna pay for deluxe or gold or reloaded or whatever it is with more content and whatever and stuff that costs more than $60. They can't keep dreaming about it that I was going to pay extra money in more and more for those games.
Yeah, they can forget about it.
I need to change your weapon since I'm out of ammo. I really hate this new business marketing that they put in the games for microtransactions. I freaking can't stand it. I really can't stand it. Especially cosmetics, oh man, they offer money for cosmetics, such as what was game that for haircut, you want to change haircut, you need to pay $1. What game what does, oh my god, I forgot. That was just ridiculous. I'm just staring there with my eyes open and the jaw dropped to the ground. You want more money and more money, you can go suck an egg. Corresponding proton rifle, oh yeah, that's beautiful, with fire element, yes. Anything new here while I was gone? Looks like T-scaling to my level, that's excellent. No, even more, I can't use it, I'm 44, right? Right? I would like to hear your opinion in the comments, what you think about the microtransaction. I'm more or less with on the same opinion as Review Tech USA. I may prefer to pay up more upfront, let's say, 70 or 18 bucks and have no microtransaction whatsoever, rather than pay for microtransaction later. Ooh, COV, that's interesting. Let me try it. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I didn't see this weapon in a long time. Basically a laser. I'm gonna try and make some space for it. Maybe drop something I don't really need, like this. Something that can go away so I can keep it. This 8,000, that's very good prices. There are things here that don't even cost a margin of this. Let's see, 4,000. That's legendary. What about you? 4,000, okay. The sniper rifle, we can put it back in our bank in Sanctuary. 4,000, okay. Looks like everything I pick up is no slouch in money now, huh? 3,000, really. Max health. If I weren't needing that, I would toss it away. Max health, 5 for your life. Okay, that's a good relic, so I can't toss it. Oh, you. 4,000, really? This toy-like weapon, 4,000. TDR. 7,000. Jacob's usually not that costly, not that pricey. What's going on? 9,000, man. Well, I have to get rid of something here. Yeah, 4,000. I'll make more from you, more 4,000. So where to next? What of quest? This one is super messy, probably travel. Yeah, not relevant right now. Okay, it's back. Looks like this map is huge. Crimson Radio, Clappy, we found one more Typhoon Logan. We finish it and Crimson Radio. Crimson Radio shouldn't be this hard. Can't believe it, the people in this age still accept microtransactions, man. It's a plague on this industry. It's annoying, it's pissing me off. I will never ever pay for it. I usually always buy the standard game. The even Borderlands.
Those Malawan must want that vault bad. What if they know I already opened the sucker years ago?
Even Borderlands 3, when I bought the version, I paid the standard version with no errors. They wanted the deluxe, get a gold weapon, or gold, get some content, get some maps, some season pass thrown in there, get some... what they wanted, golden weapon, some relics, some cosmetics with some...
accessories.
Come on, what the hell?
Don't pee on it this time.
Yeah, don't pee on it, blaster. That's beautiful blaster radiation. So many beautiful pistols and guns that I don't have inventory for, or I just have superior weapons to use. So yeah, you know, I bought the standard version, 60 bucks. Man, they wanted more money, trying to milk me and trying to get more money from me. So I paid them a gold standard from some golden weapon at start or some skin packs. You milking trash. Can't stand it when companies do that, man. Especially Ubisoft, especially guilty. They have like 100 choices between, let's say, Assassin's Creed Odyssey, for example. Deluxe editions, definitive editions. No, definitive, no. It's always about the some remasters, but deluxe, gold, silver, full, ultra, whatever. You catch my point. Can't stand it, man. Like, it's really nothing useful. It's not like you can beat the game without it. Or Assassin's Creed Odyssey, where you can buy XP boosts or buy some invincible horse or whatever, or some cosmetic to look better, or weapon, or boost your experience so you don't grind. You're paying money to shorten your game and experience? Like, what the hell? I don't understand that. Like Angry Joe called it time savings. Yeah, come on, you idiot, you more than just buy our time savings. Get more XP. The industry wasn't like this, let's say, 10 years ago. For example, 2010 was starting, but I'm talking about 2006, 7 at least. I remember Dead Space 3 when it came out, that was most guilty of it. Melter, that's beautiful Melter. Crying in the area. Do love it, do want it. And the price, 6,000. So yeah.
Let them hear your rage.
Sniper rifle, Hyperion, right? Gotta be. Gotcha. Gotcha. Not critical, disappointed, but this is dead. Critical!
A slaughter to remember!
Let me try this one. This one is precision and very powerful. Oh, there is a bad guy. Wow, that's extremely powerful. Two hits! Whoa, that shotgun is powerful. Yeah, he moved. Unfair.
Pathetic end for a pathetic creature.
Wow, that shotgun is incredibly powerful. Badass, went like it was nothing. Look at this, one shot to the head, done. Insane. I don't like to be so overpowered. I like when it's balanced and stuff. I love it nicely balanced. So it's difficult for you. It's not easy. You're dying pretty fast, which I hate in Borderlands. No matter how you spec your character. Let's say Ultimate on Hunter mode in Borderlands 2, that just pissed me off. Enemies constantly regenerate health. Other weapons obsolete. Some tech weapons obsolete. And you... white gear, green gear just won't cut it. I remember I just played the first time Ultimate World Hunter mode. My gun Zerker was going down all the time. Enemies put you down like in two hits. That was insanely unbalanced. I hated that. True World Hunter mode, that was amazing. It was balanced. The badass enemies would be more. Drop rates would increase and it would be tough. You wouldn't die so quickly. Yeah, you will went down. Not as quickly, and the enemies were challenging. I like this balance between challenge and difficulty, you know? I hate it when it's too easy. That's what I'm dreaming to when I finish this let's play of Borderlands, start the let's play of Doom Eternal with ultra violence, even though I'm afraid to do it because from all the reviews I've seen in gameplay, people complain that it's too damn hard. And if you don't pay 100% attention and concentration to the game, well, Doom Eternal is just damn hard and you have to somehow adapt. Well, when I get my hands on that game, I'll give it a try.